Okay, hello, welcome. Give me a second just to go over your chart real quick, okay? How are you? How did you hear about us? You put the jukebox combination skin. Yeah, I see what you mean. It's a little bit. Well, I'll take a closer look in a minute, but yeah, great. Have you ever had an oil facial before? First time? It's just really relaxing, honestly. You know, it's not like the other ones where you do extractions and you're kind of, you know, a little bit bruised and battered afterwards. This one's very, more similar to just a massage. Okay, a massage for your face, basically. So, very relaxing. Any allergies that you know of? Any questions for me or concerns? Okay. I'm gonna set this down here. So I have probably gonna use 3, maybe 4. Let me take a closer look at your skin. Different oils on you. Can you touch your head a little bit? Okay. Yeah, I see what you mean. You got kind of a oily forehead, but then your cheeks kind of dry out, almost a little rosacea. What kind of products do you normally use at home? Like your just cleanser. I'll start with that. Tea tree cleanser, okay. It's really good. You know, tea tree has a natural antiseptic qualities for you and antifungal, so it's a good, it's very gentle on your skin as well. It's excellent. Okay. What about your makeup? Are you washing those brushes? How often? Okay, I'd probably step it up a little bit more because, you know, when you're putting your makeup on, you're using those brushes that bacteria just goes right into them, and if you're not washing them, you're just putting bacteria back on your face. So it's definitely a good idea to try your best to wash them pretty regularly, okay? That will help. Okay. Okay, so I think I want to start one with this. So I've got a couple different ones. We're just going to start with some vitamin E oil, very moisturizing, and we'll start from there, and then we'll get a hot towel afterwards that kind of open you up for the rest of it, okay? Just want to rub this in. A few drops, you don't really need a whole lot. nice down on the cheek, under your eyes, other eyes. Okay, just rub it all in. You got a very nice skin. And I think you'll find this to be a very lovely effect on your skin. It's going to make you look so glowing and healthy and vibrant. Okay. So let me get a hot towel. We'll put it over your face for a minute and then we'll continue. Okay, I'll be right back. Put it on your face a little bit. Sorry, it's kind of in your eyes, isn't it? A little bit. Trying to get it so it's not so bad. Okay. Is that alright? Okay. Not too hot, not too cold. So I like your cleanser that you're using. That's a good one. And just let that sit for a second. I'm gonna review some things on your chart. It says here that you're also maybe interested in an extracting facial, which is, you know, very different. Of course, we do that here. It's just going to be a little bit more intense, okay? You're going to look a little flushed afterwards. Have you ever had one of those before? Okay. Feels so nice and warm. Sometimes you don't want to take it off. I know how that is. My grandma used to wake me up with a hot washcloth, and it was always one of the best ways to wake up. I felt so kind of hot. Okay, nice and opened up. All right, so I'm going to use rosehip oil on you, very moisturizing, and you can use this for a couple different applications, your hair, your skin, your nails. I find it to be very, very good, and got a little bit of a yellow tint to it. I also put rosehip powder in my morning smoothie sometimes. It's very good for your body. Okay. Just a nice feeling, isn't it? Kind of healing, calming. Our side. The only problem with waking me up that way is when you get kind of hot to it too. It's warm and it feels comfy when it's on, but when she took it off, your skin's that much more cold. So it's hard to be thrilled about that part when she took it off, but it was effective. Nice warm feeling, and then all of a sudden you're cold. Kind of makes you. So, you can try that sometime. Try that on somebody else, maybe. Maybe just one more little dot. Give that just about a minute to settle in there, and I'll just kind of get to know you a little bit better. Any siblings? I have one older sister who we were very, very close growing up. She's about 2 years older than I am, 2.5. We were very close. Hardly ever argued, unless it was the morning, because I was kind of a bit of a brat in the morning, to be honest. And just, it's hard for me to wake up. And she's the opposite. She bounces out of bed and is so excited for the day. It is really hard to deal with that kind of in-your-face energy, right, when you wake up for me. So that was pretty much the only time of day that we would fight. In the mornings, for the most part, having your siblings do occasionally fight, but we got along really well. Okay, I'm gonna put this jojoba oil on it. I always pronounce it wrong, but this one's also really good for your hair and your skin and your nails. They put it in a lot of different like hair oils now, so I've been noticing this. Definitely starting to trend up a little bit on that level. Yeah, my sister and I were pretty close growing up, and then I kind of got these bonus sisters because, you know, she has friends, and then they come over her, and then they end up being, you know, adapted to kind of her friends being over, and you get these bonus sisters. So I have a few of those. My dad, I guess, I don't have actually a memory of this happening, but it's a story he told me later about, I guess, one time we were really fighting, and he got frustrated and brought us inside because we were playing outside in the backyard, and he sat us down, and he got real stern with us, and he was like, you guys are sisters, you're siblings, you love each other, that's it, we don't fight, and we really didn't. We learned that that was the expectation, and it was not going to be, you know, looked upon positively. And there's one thing that my sister and I, we definitely are people pleasers. We try to, you know, make everybody feel good. And we didn't want to upset them. So and I was there for the most part, we didn't really fight too much. Okay, I'm going to settle a little bit. Put the lid back on this guy. I also had a few of my parents, friends, and colleagues that we all had every Friday that we spent together. So I had, you know, my sister and my sister's friends, and then this other group that we hung out with, and there's two more kids in that group too, so there's a little foursome of that group. So, and there was one of the younger ones. So I always felt like I had a lot of guidance, I guess, growing up. My grandparents, my parents, my sister and her friends, and then this other group too. So I had a lot of people telling me things sometimes that I didn't want to hear, but it's okay. So this one, this one's vitamin C serum. 30%, it helps with, you know, kind of repairing your skin, moisturizing, like the other two, big on moisturizing today. And yeah, it's just really good for any blemishes or fine lines and wrinkles and those kinds of things. So we'll pop this on there and home. So I'm gonna need to get some more soon. I do use a retinol and hyaluronic acid serum as well, but for today we're just doing the oil massage. So any another time we can have you come back and get something a little different. Maybe the extracting or the acne prone skin facial. We've quite a few. So I'll hand you a brochure when you leave, okay? When you check out, you can take a look at all the different ones we have and decide whether or not And you want to try the other side. So, a little bit thicker. Try to warm it up a little bit. Hopefully it's not too bad. And of course, as always, anytime you come in here, I'm going to remind you to, you know, hydrate. Alright. Hydrate. Drink plenty of fluids, not soda. Water. Nothing sugary because it does do affect your skin. And then of course sunscreen when you go out, okay, especially now it's starting to get nicer out. So and even those cloud covers, I made the same mistake. I got burnt pretty badly this year already because it was overcast and I was thinking, well, it's not too bad, I'm not going to be out here for that long. But I do put on a daily sunscreen moisturizer on my face. So my face actually was pretty okay. It was my shoulders that really got the brunt of it. But I feel like I learned this lesson every year. The first few times I go out and then I am good. But I don't know why I can't figure it out more than that. Especially since I preach it, you know. I did do an okay job on my face because it was covered. Look up for me real quick and I'll get ready. And then close your eyes. But I shouldn't be complaining about the sun, at least we're getting it again. It was quite rainy actually a couple days ago here. And I was glad because then I didn't have to water my plants. But I stayed inside, curled up with a little book. Okay, that looks pretty good. Give it another minute and let it soak into your skin a little bit. Make sure I'm gonna just take these clothes off because I think we're done. Do you have any questions or concerns or anything for me? So you are more than welcome to hang out in this room for a little bit. You know, you got the candles and I'll dim the lights maybe a little bit. And you can hang out here. Okay, when you're ready, come on out. I'm gonna take your chart to the front desk, and we'll put you in our system again, and we'll kind of arrange sure if you have any questions for other facials or want to make an appointment. You can do that then, alright. But yeah, take your time. Okay. Okay. I hope you're feeling very relaxed. And refreshed. And there's a mirror on that wall, obviously you can check it out when I leave, okay? Okay. Thank you for coming in. We'll see you next time.